Greetings everyone. Today I am going to test two of my M2 SSDs. The first one is my current C drive SanDisk Ultra M2 NVMe 3D SSD. Let me show you. You see it is almost full currently. Therefore I have purchased another SSD and I have just installed it into the computer and I haven't even initialized it yet. The other one is Kingston NV2 SSD. The form factor is M2 2280. It is 2 terabyte version and I am going to use all of the major popular benchmarking software. Let me show you them, each one of them. Unreal Storage, Auto Disk Benchmark, Crystal Disk Mark, and as SSD benchmark. So this is my current list. Let me show. This is my current C drive SSD. First I will do a test of it, then I will clone it bit by bit to my new hard drive, restart Windows, and I will do tests on them. So you will be able to compare both hard drive features, both hard drive speeds. Also, I will make another video and I will show how I am going to clone my current M2 SSD to my new M2 SSD. And before starting, let me also show how am I going to initialize newly installed SSD. I have typed control panel, administrative tools, and from here, computer management. And from storage, disk management. And in here, you see it is unallocated. I'm going to set a simple volume. And with this way, you can assign it to a new drive. But I'm not going to assign it right now because I'm going to clone this drive into that one. And one more thing. I have made a stability test before logging into the Windows, and in the motherboard both have passed. So let me quickly show the information of my computer. I have Intel Core i7 10700F version CPU. My main board is Mach B 460M mortar, and I have 64 gigabytes memory, as you can see here. Okay, now I will do each of the benchmarks one by one. Okay, let's start. Okay, so the first test has been completed with Crystal Disk Mark 8.0.4x64 version. The versions are important. We have sequential 1 megabyte reads, as you see, like this. These are the values. I think this is pretty decent. As you consider that I have total read as 23 terabyte and total write as 37 terabyte. I also have opened CPU-Z SPD information if you wonder. Now let's move to our next test, which is Auto Disk Benchmark 4.00.0F2. Let's start. Okay, so Auto Disk Benchmark has also been completed. You see, after certain file size, the speeds are not changing, as you can see. Also, don't worry that I am going to provide all of the application download links that I am using right now in the description of the video as well, so you will be able to also download them and test them. Okay, now let's move to our next benchmark, which is SSD benchmark 2.0 point, and the other thing is going like this. So I'm not changing the default values, the sizes here, as you can see. Okay, so this benchmark has also been completed, and these are the values. As you can see, it is pretty decent. And now our final test, which is Unreal Storage Utilities. Actually, this is pretty old testing benchmark. These are much more recent than this one. Okay, let's start it. Okay, so the test has been completed and these are the values that we have obtained. So let's take a screenshot of these results, save them, and after that I will clone this disk into the NIF disk and restart window and repeat the test, so we will be able to compare them. So I'm going to click print screen, open my paint.net. Okay, and in here I am selecting the cropping tool. Okay, this is also another thing that you are learning right now. Okay, and let's save it into the desktop as test results. Okay, it is save it and now ready. Okay. Okay, now I have cloned my SSD into the NIF drive and opened the windows. Let me show you. So you see my C drive is now 2 terabyte, and this is the older drive I just had completed the tests on. I have opened the software. Let me show you the disk info from here. Okay, so this is our C drive currently. So you see this is the total host reads and this is total host writes so far, and power on hours and everything is like this. So let's start our tests. Tests have been completed. Now we are going to compare each one of them individually with the previous hard disk test results. Okay, the first results are for Autodisk Benchmark. As you can see, there is a huge difference in the small size data read and data write. It is 3 times faster in data writing. In reading, it is almost 2 times faster. Actually, if it is 1 kilobyte data, it is, I can see, 4 times faster for reading. So in small sizes, it is much better. For bigger size data read and data write, the write is almost 1.5 times faster, as you can see, and reading is almost same, but in small sizes the difference is significant. So I can say that the new hard disk is much better overall. Okay, so I have opened the correct version of Crystal Disk Mark. Okay, now we have a fair comparison between the same version of Crystal Disk Mark, as you can see. So you see the difference is significant once again. Only this one is a little bit worse, but in other areas, yeah, it is better overall. But the difference in Crystal Disk Mark is not as significant as in Autodisk Benchmark. I don't know why. Okay, now let's compare Anvil Storage. Anvil Storage also providing us a total score. As you can see, the total score is almost as high, about 1.5 times. So let's look at the numbers. So the number of megabyte we read, sequential 4 megabyte is much better, and 4K much better. So overall, a significant improvement in Anvil Storage Benchmark as well, as supposed to be. Okay. Anvil Storage Benchmark also shows all of the information in here and in here as well. So it's a fair, it provides a fair and clear comparison for us. Okay, and the last comparison is for us SSD Benchmark. You see same version. And once again, there is a significant increase, but not as significant as in Anvil Storage or Atto Benchmark. So we have got about, let's say, 30% increase in total score. The read score is almost same, but the write score is much better with the new SSD. Okay. Okay, this is all for this video. I am going to upload a video about how did I clone and verify the file's integrity. So if you wonder how did I clone my previous C drive into my NIF M2 SSD drive, check that out video as well. It is not on the page right now as I am recording, but it will be when you are watching, hopefully. Also, if you like it, please like, subscribe, and if you support us on our Patreon, we would appreciate very much. This is totally optional, but it would help us to make more and better quality videos, hopefully. Hopefully see you in another video.